More than 10 million people around the world have active tuberculosis, and every year more than 1 million people die from it, mostly in lower resource countries. Diagnosing TB in these settings is quite difficult. The historic standard of gathering a sputum sample and culturing it is slow and often not sensitive enough to correctly identify tuberculosis. And there are newer sensitive methods that are very high quality, but they require equipment and infrastructure that just isn't available in many of the local communities where it's needed.
So we have created a fast multiplexed ultrasensitive TB diagnostic test that analyzes the levels of four proteins and an anti-TB antibody in blood to distinguish patients who have TB, active TB, from those who look like they have TB but have other respiratory diseases. Our test had very good accuracy and demonstrated an 86% sensitivity and a specificity of 69%, which is very close to the World Health Organization's target parameters of 90% sensitivity and specificity of 70% for an effective triage test. That is a test that can be used by local providers in local settings to determine which patients need to be taken to a clinic for further evaluation and definitive TB diagnosis. Now, our test also performed very well on patients and samples across three different continents. And that means that the TB test is effective in all types of TB strains. And it was also effective on HIV positive and HIV negative samples. And that's very important because in resource poor settings, a lot of patients who get HIV also get TB.
The best part of our platform is that it can be configured into an easy to use point of care diagnostic test that costs only about $2, and it gives a result within 30 minutes. My lab at the Wyss Institute and the Brigham and Women's Hospital is continuing to work with Rushdie and Michael's team at the Broad Institute to refine and improve this test. And we hope that in the near future, it will be used to triage patients with active TB and get them the treatment they need, potentially saving millions of lives.